皆様、本日は
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for attending the Japan Prize 2023 presentation ceremony.
誠にありがとうございます。
My name is Yuriko Murakami, an NHK announcer, and I will be the master of ceremonies. Now I would like to introduce the organizers of the Japan Prize and the members of the Field Selection Committee and the Selection Committee.Yoshio Yazaki, Chairman of the Japan Prize Foundation, the organizer of the Japan Prize. Masayuki Oku, Chairman of the Board of Counselors, Japan Prize Foundation. Vice Chairman of the Field Selection Committee, Dr. Kazuhito Hashimoto, President of Japan Science and Technology Agency.Chairman of the Selection Committee, Dr. Makoto Asashima, Director of Institute for Advanced Study, Teikyo University. Vice Chairman of the Selection Committee, Dr. Yoichiro Matsumoto, Professor Emeritus, the University of Tokyo.Chairman of Electronics, Information and Communications Committee, Dr. Hiroto Yasura, Vice President of National Institute of Informatics, Inter-University Research Institute for Information and Systems.Life Sciences Committee Chairman, Dr. Kyosuke Nagata, President of University of Tsukuba. Acting Chair of Electronics, Information and Communication Committee, Dr. Hironori Kasahara, Professor, Department of Information Science and Technology, Faculty of Science and Engineering, Waseda University.Acting Chair of Life Sciences Committee, Dr. Shigeo Koyasu, President of National Institute of Quantum Science and Technology, Japan. Thank you very much.
ではご来賓の皆様のご入場です。
Now the guests of honor are now entering the hall.
皆様をご紹介申し上げます。
Now I would like to introduce the guests of honor.
参議院議長、尾辻秀久様。
The Honorable Hidehisa Otsuji, Speaker of the House of Counselors.
最高裁判所長官。
The Honorable Saburo Tokura, Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. The Honorable Keiko Nagaoka, Minister of Education, Culture, Sports, Science and Technology. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, their Majesties, the Emperor and the Empress. We would now like to welcome the 2023 Japan Prize laureates. Please remain seated and welcome the laureates with a round of applause. First, in the field of electronics, information and communication, Professor Masataka Nakazawa, Mr. Kazuo Hagimoto, the laureates. Next, in the field of life sciences, Professor Gero Miesenbeck and Professor Carl Dysaroth.
Please be seated. The 2023 Japan Prize Presentation Ceremony will now begin. The national anthem will be played. Please rise. Please take seats.
はじめに主催者を代表いたしまして、
Dr. Hiroshi Komiyama, President of the Japan Prize Foundation, will deliver his greetings on behalf of the organizer. I am Hiroshi Komiyama, President of the Japan Prize Foundation, the organizer of the Japan Prize. I am honored and grateful for the presence of Their Majesties, the Emperor and Empress. It is a great pleasure for all of us to welcome Their Majesties, the Emperor and Empress, on this spring day when our everyday life is beginning to return to normal. We are also pleased to welcome the Honorable President of the House of Counselors, the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court, the Minister of Education, Culture, Sports, Science, Technology, and other senior officials of government institutions, as well as the embassies of the United States of America and the Republic of Austria. As guest of honor, thank you for your attendance. The Japan Prize was established in the early 1980s at the initiative of the Japan government to establish an internationally prestigious prize to contribute to the development of science and technology worldwide. With the support of government agencies based on a cabinet decision and with the cooperation of many people, we have been awarding scientific and technological achievements that contribute to the peace and prosperity of humankind. Humanity has accumulated a tremendous amount of knowledge and has continued to thrive as a species. There is no doubt that science and technology have been at the core of such knowledge. Furthermore, by integrating the vast amount of accumulated knowledge across disciplines, according to the purpose, we should be able to find a path to a solution to complex problems such as global warming. I believe that one of the successes is that the COVID-19 vaccine has been put to practical use and has saved many lives in the extremely short time. We must solve many of the serious, complex problems that mankind is facing with. To this end, the science and technology will require the integration of knowledge across disciplines, as well as the development of each individual field. In light of the future of science and technology, the Japan Prize has decided to extend its awards to not only individual achievements, but also group achievements. And we will ensure that the Japan Prize contributes to the development of science and technology and to the peace and the prosperity of humankind. In particular today, we should keep in mind the light and shadow of science and technology, witnessing the unceasing wars in the world and seeing the remarkable development of generative artificial intelligence. I am reminded of the both sides, the light and shadow of science and technology. I'd like to express my deep respect for the foresight of our predecessors in establishing the Japan Prize in recognition of science and technology that contribute to the peace and prosperity of humankind. And I pledge to continue to fulfill its purpose with your kind continued support. In conclusion, I wish Their Majesties, the Emperor and Empress, and all attendees the very best. Thank you very much. Next, Dr. Asashima, Chairman of the Selection Committee, will report on the selection for the 2023 Japan Prize. I am pleased to report on the selection process. In November of the year before last, we announced the definition of the cell call for applications in the fields of electronics, information and communication, and life sciences, and requested nominations from 15,500 distinguished researchers in Japan and abroad. We received 123 and 24 nominations, respectively, for a total of 327 nominations. The two selection subcommittees rigorously evaluated the nominations for academic originality and excellence, and the selection committee reviewed the nominations based on the social contribution of the discoveries and inventions of the nominees, and the foundation's board of directors made a final decision on the winners. In the field of electronics, information and communication, Professor Masataka Nakazawa, Distinguished Professor, Tohoku University, Mr. Kazuo Hagimoto, Principal Researcher, National Institute of Information and Communications Technology. The awarded achievement is distinguished contributions to global long-distance, high-capacity optical fiber networks through the development of semiconductor laser-pumped optical amplifier. In the field of life sciences, Professor Gyalo Miesenbeck, Winfried Professor of Physiology, University of Oxford, Professor Carl Dyseroth, Stanford University. The awarded achievements are the development of methods that use genetically addressable light-sensitive membrane proteins to unravel neural circuit function. We extend our heartfelt congratulations to these individuals and laureates for their achievements, which are worthy of Japan Prize.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
それではこれより日本国際賞
We will now present the Japan Prize.
表彰を行います。エレクトロニクス情報通信
Professor Masataka Nakazawa.
Nakazawa Masataka 博士。
And Mr. Kazuo Hagimoto, laureates in the fields of electronics, information and communication, will receive the Japan Prize Medal from Dr. Yazaki, Chairman of the Japan Prize Foundation. First, Professor Nakazawa, please proceed to the center of the stage.
おめでとうございます。
Congratulations. Mr. Hagimoto, could you please proceed to the center of the stage?
おめでとうございます。
Congratulations.Ladies and gentlemen, let us congratulate the laureates with a big round of applause.
Next, Dr. Gyalo Miesenbeck and Dr. Carl Dyseroth, laureates in the field of life sciences.Will be presented the Japan Prize medals by Dr. Yazaki, Chairman of the Japan Prize Foundation. Dr. Miesenbeck, please proceed to the center of the stage.
おめでとうございます。
Congratulations. Dr. Daiseroth, please proceed to the center of the stage. Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause.
Now, Dr. Hiroto Yasura, head of the selection in the fields of electronics, information, and communication, will now explain the reason for the prize. Japan Prize Electronics, Information and Communication. Here's the reason for the prize. Professor Masataka, Nakazawa, and Mr. Kazuo Hagimoto have contributed to the long distance and high capacity optical fiber communication network through the development and practical application of semiconductor laser pumped optical amplifiers. Their major achievement is the semiconductor laser pumped optical amplifier. Although optical communications were put to practice use in the 1980s, large power-consuming repeaters were required for every several tens of kilometers, which was a barrier to building long-distance optical communication networks. Professor Nakazawa invented a technology called EDFA, erbium-doped optical fiber amplifier, using a semiconductor laser light source, which made it possible to realize a compact, low-power optical amplifier of 10 square centimeters that amplified optical signals as light. Mr. Hagimoto has demonstrated the effectiveness of this technology by increasing the output power of this optical amplifier to a high output power and successfully achieved the world's first long-distance transmission over 200 kilometers using a 1.8 gigabit per second intensity modulated direct detection method. Within 5 years of their development, the method was adopted for use in trans-Pacific and transatlantic optical submarine cables and the construction of optical communication networks connecting the world advanced rapidly. Their achievements, which support today's internet as the foundation of the communications network that connects the world, are worthy of the 2023 Japan Prize, which recognizes their contributions to the field of electronics, information, and communications. Now we would like to welcome the laureates to give us a few words. First, Professor Masataka Nakazawa, please. This is such a great honor for me to receive the Japan Prize in the presence of Their Majesties, the Emperor and Empress of Japan, the honorable heads of the three administrative authorities, and the Minister of Education, Culture, Sports, Science, and Technology, together with Mr. Hagimoto. The device we have developed, called EDFA, is a completely new optical repeater that amplifies attenuated light in the optical fibers as light. And I think it is no exaggeration to say that the global ICT network has been realized by this device. The delay of the communication is very minimized. Today, I am happy to see this device is used not only for optical communications, but also in many other fields, such as fiber lasers, optical measurement, and signal processing researchers. Finally, I would like to thank my family for their daily support, my seniors and young researchers, and my colleagues, companies I'm still working with. They put such an effort in the researches, and my students too. Thank you very much.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
続きまして、萩本和夫様のご挨拶です。
Now I would like to invite Mr. Kazuo Hagimoto.
この度は天皇皇后両陛下ご臨席の
I am very honored to receive the prestigious Japan Prize in the presence of their majesties, the Emperor and Empress of Japan, distinguished guests, and distinguished visitors here today. And also I'd like to express my deepest gratitude to the Japan Prize Foundation, the members of the selection committee, and all of you who have supported me over the years. My family and all the related people and people in the field of electronics, I would like to share this joy and pleasure. Thank you very much.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
続きまして、生命科学分野審査部会。
Dr. Kyosuke Nagata, the chairman of the selection subcommittee for the field of life sciences, will now explain the reasons for the award. I'd like to introduce the achievements of the two laureates in the life science field. One of the key challenges in the neuroscience is to elucidate the causal relationship between the activity of individual neurons that make up a neural circuit at the behavior and the behavior of the circuit at the level of the individual organism. Although the function of neural circuits has been studied by means of drugs and electrical stimulation, the specificity of each individual cell that makes up a neural circuit and the role of each cell in the ever-changing neural activity haven't been fully elucidated. Dr. Miesenbeck established the concept that light-activated membrane proteins genetically engineered to be expressed in specific neurons can elucidate the function of neural activity at the level of individual organism. Dr. Dyself further developed a technique using microorganism-derived photoactivated proteins to elucidate the causal relationship between specific neuronal activity and functions at the organismal level with high temporal resolution. The technology for controlling neural activity using optic stimulation is expected to be applied not only in basic research, but also in the treatment of blind patients and in treatment of Parkinson's disease patients. Thus, the achievements of Dr. Miesenbeck and Dr. Dyself are worthy of the 2023 Japan Prize, which recognizes their contributions in the field of life sciences.
それでは受賞者の皆様よりご挨拶をいただきます。
Thank you very much. Now I would like to invite the laureates to give us some words. First, Dr. Miesenbeck, please.
Your Majesties, Excellencies, members of the selection committees and the Japan Prize Foundation, distinguished guests.The mathematician G.H. Hardy described the pleasure of discovery as a cerebral chill. Carl and I have certainly experienced that chill when our efforts to remote control the activity of the brain with light succeeded, and perhaps even more so when, thanks to our invention, we discovered some of the neural processes that underpin our lives. Today's festive occasion, though,evokes a different kind of emotion, not a cerebral chill, but a heartfelt delight at the great honor you have bestowed upon us, at the warm hospitality that you have shown us, and at the message that you have sent through the award of this prize, that fundamental research is of benefit to humankind. Thank you.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much. Now I'd like to invite Dr. Carl Dysaros to give us a few words.
Your Majesties, honored guests, friends, and family, it is my great honor to accept the 2023 Japan Prize along with my friend and co-laureate, Garo Miesenbeck. It is a sign of the times that events and discoveries from unexpected directions turn out to be important in ways that we cannot predict, and the story of optogenetics is one of those.The use of light to control individual cells in the service of understanding complex systems, even as intricate as the mammalian brain, is a wonderful example of this. Who could have predicted that genes from microorganisms like algae would be important to understand ourselves? But this is the story of science. This is the story of the human march toward the future and toward understanding.It's been almost 20 years since our first steps along this path were taken. Much has happened, but much remains to be done. I'm tremendously grateful to all those who've shared this journey, to my students and postdoctoral fellows for their brilliance, to my patients in the clinic who've inspired me every day, to my family, my wonderful family who has stoodby my side and helped me, and to my brave daughters, Emma and Sophie, who accompanied me here, wonderful travelers, and their fearlessness inspires me. And I think this is, in some ways, why we're all here. We need to be unafraid in seeking freedom and truth together. Thank you very much.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
ここで天皇陛下より
At this point, His Majesty the Emperor will give us a few words.
2023
Japan Prize Japan Prize presentation ceremony. It brings me great pleasure to be here at the 2023 Japan Prize presentation ceremony, together with distinguished participants and guests from different countries and regions of the world on the occasion of this esteemed ceremony. I would like to extend my heartfelt congratulations to each of the distinguished laureates, Professor Masataka Nakazawa and Mr. Kazuo Hagimoto in the field of electronics information and communication, and Professor Gero Mizubek and Professor Carl Dysart in the field of life sciences. The Japan Prize was established based on private donations in accordance with the Japanese government's vision of contributing to the development of science and technology throughout the world. This prize is awarded to scientists and engineers from across the globe who have made innovative and groundbreaking achievements that have made a significant contribution to the advancement of science and technology, and recognized for their remarkable efforts to contribute to the peace and prosperity of humankind. I would like to convey my deepest regards to each of these outstanding researchers whose studies have contributed immensely to the growth of various scientific and technological fields and to the improved well-being of humanity. Today, nations around the world, including our country, are facing many social, economic, and environmental challenges, and science and technology are playing increasingly crucial roles as we have worked together to overcome the COVID-19 pandemic during the past few years. I believe that by gathering the wisdom of diverse fields and joining forces worldwide, we can build a promising future. I would like to conclude by expressing my sincere hope that the Japan Prize will further aid the advancement of science and technology to bring happiness to people and also contribute to the peace and prosperity of humankind. Thank you.
Honorable Hidehisa Otsuji, the Chairman of the House of Councillors, will deliver his congratulations on behalf of the distinguished guests. Every speaker has made excellent short speeches, whereas what I prepared as a congratulatory message, I am now afraid of is a bit longer than those ones. But since I prepared, let me go through as I prepared. I'd like to read them out from the bottom of my heart. In the presence of their majesties, the Emperor and Empress, I'd like to take this opportunity to greet you at the 2023 Japan Prize presentation ceremony. I'd like to extend my sincere congratulations to the laureates of the prestigious Japan Prize and to their families and friends who have supported them over the years. The laureates of this year's award are shining brightly right now, and the light is a key word in your research achievements as well. The work of Dr. Masataka Nakazawa and Mr. Kazuo Hagimoto, principal researcher, has formed the basis for the stable supply of optical communication systems. If it had not been for the two of them at the dawn of the system construction period, who had accomplished the construction of a system that was considered difficult to put into practical use. The establishment of the current global internet society would have been much slower. Thanks to their efforts and achievements, the world is now connected by an optical information and communication network. Similarly, our bodies have an endless number of neural circuits that transmit information. We move our limbs and think about things because those complex neural circuits correctly transmit information. It was Dr. Gero Miesenbeck who demonstrated the usefulness of using light to unravel the workings of these circuits. Dr. Carl Dieseroth paved the way for its application in a wide range of research. This technology has now become indispensable in neuroscience research, and I hear that it has great potential for medical applications as well. Light is hope. 3 years ago, a new type of coronavirus, COVID-19, emerged as an unknown entity in front of the human race, killing many people around the world. Although there is no way to heal the sorrow, science, technology, and medicine have remained a ray of light and hope in the face of the COVID-19 pandemic disaster, which seems to have no end in sight. The research that the laureates have devoted their lives to is truly worthy of the Japan Prize, which honors the wisdom of science and contributions to society. And I'd like to express my sincere respect for their great achievements. I'd like to conclude my congratulatory address by expressing my hope that the Japan Prize will continue to contribute to the advancement of science and technology in the world and play an even more important role in promoting peace and prosperity for mankind. April 13, 2023. Hidesa Otsuji, Chairman of the House of Councillors. With this, we conclude the 2023 Japan Prize presentation ceremony. Their Majesties, the Emperor and Empress, now leave the hall. Please be seated.
ご来賓の皆様のご退場でございます。
The distinguished guests will now leave, starting from Honorable Otsuji, the Speaker of the House of Representatives.
受賞者の皆様のご退席です。
The award laureates will now leave. Congratulations to all of you. Please see them off with a big round of applause. Congratulations.This concludes the 2023 Japan Prize Presentation Ceremony. Today's string quartet and harp were played by Miss Yuko Kiyoka, first violin,
second violin.
Miss Tamaki Muratsu, second violin. Miss Yuko Ando, viola. Mr. Takui Matsumoto, cello. Miss Aya Horigome, harp of the Tokyo National University of Fine Arts and Music. Thank you very much.Thank you very much for your attendance today.